Everybody
gets just on board the boats that were handy.
The lifeboats.
Lifeboats, but there were 6,000 or more on board, which they wouldn't all fit in all the boats. So most
there,
of us
you're
had
saying
to
there wasn't enough lifeboats,
right,
for 6,000 troops. It was like the Titanic.
Right.
Yeah. So it was every man for himself, so to speak.
Yeah.
And
so I had to go jump overboard and swim.
Without a life jacket?
Without, yeah.
You just.
It's about, let's say, a half a mile.
So you hit the water, this is in the morning.
Yeah.
So there had to be hundreds of people.
Oh, yeah.
In the water.
Quite a few didn't make it.
Yeah, well, it must have been just a wild scene with people splashing around in the water.
Yeah, it was a pretty rough sea, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You probably couldn't see a lot of people if you were in rough sea. Yeah.
No,
but you saw the island.
Yeah.
So you knew where you were trying to get
to.
Oh,
yeah, we knew where we were going at.
Yeah, so you started swimming towards the island.
Excuse me.
You started swimming towards the island.
Yeah.
But that water is extremely cold.
Oh, it was, yes.
Yeah, so hypothermia is a real.
Oh, quite a few had a hypothermia.
Yeah. And when did you know that you actually, had feet, something solid under you? Do you remember?
Oh, it took about 20 minutes.
You were swimming for 20 minutes?
Yeah.
That's a pretty good swim. In choppy water and cold?
Well, a lot of them, like I say, didn't make it.
And there are no statistics of how many people drowned? And
no, I don't.
No, I mean, 6,000 minutes of water, they don't know how many came out.
I know quite a few come out because they were picked up over there and brought into San Francisco.
Now, this island, it was inhabited?
No.
It was barren island?
It had a, what the heck they call it?
A lighthouse?
Lighthouse.
Yeah.
And that's what most of us saw when we get up,
So you saw the lighthouse when you went out into the ocean?
Right.
Now, you must have been cold and wet.
Yeah.
I mean, how long before they actually were kind of rescued?
I made it in about 20 minutes, and then we stayed aboard for about, I'd say, a day and a half.
You were in this. You were on this island a day and a half?
Yeah, no food there, no nothing, and no shelter.
It must have been cold, though.
And then the Coast Guard came out and picked us up quite a few.
Why did it take so long? I mean, San Francisco wasn't all that far, was it?
Oh, it's quite away from San Francisco. It was about, I'd say, 40, 45 miles up the coast.
Yeah, it's still not a day and a half. Well, I don't know. But you had a bunch of cold, wet, scared people sitting on the island, so.
Right.
So, anyway, you finally got rescued and you go to San Francisco.
Right.
And then you said the train ride back to the Boston area is even worse than. You remember the train ride?
Terrible, terrible.
Yeah.
No windows. They were all broken out. No doors to go in and out of. Mm-hmm. Everybody was freezing.
Yeah.
It was about the middle of winter. And it took us quite a while. They at the Boston, and when I got to Boston,
you were ready to be discharged.
I caught pneumonia.
Oh, that's right too. Yes.
Caught pneumonia,
and
I was in the hospital about 2 or 3 months.
With the Chelsea.
Chelsea Naval.
Hospital. Well, anyway, then you finally get discharged.
Yeah, finally.
And you returned back to Watertown, and. You married in June of 1947, Nikki Arno.
Arnone.
And she was from East Boston.
East Boston, yeah.
And you have had three children, Joanne, Donna, and Steve.
Yeah.
And you are a grandfather 4 times,
right.
All boys.
All boys.
And you got your GED, your high school graduation,
certificate
at the veterans ceremony that was orchestrated by our veterans officer, does a wonderful job, Bob Erickson, and back to Will. Now, Will, you separate. You finally get back to San Diego, and you get discharged June of 1946.
Right.
And you then go to work, and you had a 45-year career, unbroken, with Baird Corporation. And one of the things that you were working on, which is kind of interesting because it's used today, is night vision goggles. And what was that?
Night vision?
Yeah.
Yeah, they at one time, my company, this was in the 80s, we were probably the biggest supplier of night vision equipment to the Army. And when I'm talking, when I say night vision equipment, I'm talking about night vision driver's viewers for tanks and night vision goggles, you know, to put on your face. Mm-hmm. And I don't know what happened. I left in 87, and the company was bought out by another company, a New Jersey outfit. Mm-hmm. And I think the company just disappeared now. It got split up into different factions. Mm-hmm. The commercial division was sold to one group, and the government systems division was sold to another group. So the company, as I knew it when I worked for it, went out of existence.
Mm-hmm. But Baird Atomic, but not Baird Atomic, the Baird Corporation.
Baird Corporation.
Is
now gone.
Yeah. But you spent the 45 years with them.
I spent 45 years with them,
and you
including service time.
Okay, and you retired as a contract manager.
I was when I retired, I was the contracts manager.
Yep. And Dominic, you were a cabinet maker your entire life, and retired as a cabinet maker.
Yes.
And you married in 1971, and to Emma.
No, I was married in 1952.
52. Okay. Okay. You moved to Watertown in 1971.
I moved to Watertown in 1971, right.
And you live on King Street and
Cypress
Street. And you lost Emma in 1977, your wife. But you have one daughter, Susan.
One daughter, Susan, and two grandchildren.
And two grandchildren. You are a member of the AMVETS,
I'm not a member of the AMVETS. I'm a member of the VFW.
VFW.
And the American Legion.
American Legion. And you're a member of the band.
I'm a member of the American Legion band.
And what's your...
I'm a non-playing member.
Now, what do you do?
I carry the banner.
All right. And on a Memorial Day parade, you'll be in Watertown, you'll be carrying the banner.
I'll be carrying the banner.
And we're all going to be looking for you. Well, gentlemen, this has been a fascinating stories of your veteran stories, your lives. And I would like to close by asking you if you would like to dedicate this story, this fascinating story, to anybody that you would like. And I'll start with you.
Yeah, I'd like to dedicate it to my wonderful, beautiful daughter, Susan, whose name is now Susan Newton. She's just the apple of my eye, the greatest daughter that I could ever imagine. And to her, I dedicate this whole story.
Thank you. And to you, who would you like to dedicate the story to?
My wife.
To? Your wife?
For 51 years. And we had a good life.
Gentlemen, thank you for being a part of and telling your story. It was a very good year, a veteran story, and I would like to close by also thanking Bob Erickson for making this program possible, and we will see you next time.